G'day everybody, welcome back to Starfield. Hope you guys are doing well. We are in Akila City's spaceport right now. There's our ship. Andresia's with us, and we're here because there are a couple of side quests that we could potentially do here in Akila City. So let's get stuck into it. Now, in the previous episode, I was sort of a bit disappointed about the whole copper delivery to Tobias. And I was hoping that perhaps maybe we might be able to come back and see if he would accept the copper, or whether or not the whole thing is bugged, or I don't know, or maybe the whole copper thing is something that we have to do after making a decision for the crucible. But anyway, regardless of that, we will take a look at these quest lines in Akila City, and once we're done, I think we'll go back to Operation Starseed. And if we just can't hand in the copper to Tobias, then I'm just gonna, you know, make a decision on one of the options for the clones, and we'll see where that takes us. Because yeah, I don't really want to hang around with that mission for too long, like we are with the ECS Constance. Is this someone? No. Okay. Seems very, very still. Right. So apparently the person we need to speak to is, yeah, still hanging out here in front of the barracks. Let's have a chat.
People around here think we own Akila. They're wrong. The Ashta do.
Friend, I gotta confess, I'm not much in the mood for conversation. I know, I shouldn't let that woman get up under my skin, but, well, I can't seem to help it.
Yeah, I know the conversation happened a little bit a while ago, so some of the responses don't really make sense here. What was that all about anyway?
Girl comes in here with her big ideas about how we defend our city. No respect for the way we've done things for years. No worries about the possible consequences. And expect us to thank her for making our lives more difficult. I tell you, I've never seen entitlement like that.
It all sounds pretty overblown.
I assure you, it is not. Look, this ain't New Atlantis. It ain't all flowers and chirping birds out there. These walls around us, they're here for a damn good reason. I've trained the guards here for years, again, for a damn good reason. We get it wrong, we not watching all the time, then the ash to kill innocent people. That's the simple reality of the situation. So when someone struts in the town with their untested ideas on how to do things better, then those of us who dedicated our lives to protecting the city, that don't go over so well.
Okay, it sounds pretty closed off to new ideas, let's just say. Who knows? I mean, if new ideas are not tested, how do we know if they're better or worse? What's she trying to do?
I don't know, some technical mumbo-jumbo about sensors and behavior predictions. That's not the point. She expects us to just change up how things work, and I can't abide by it. We've gotten along just fine until now.
If security can be improved, that's a win for everyone.
Mm-mm. That's a big if, and I'm not about to do a live test of whatever tech she thinks she got. Look, this is getting my blood pressure up talking about this so damn much. You think you can talk some sense into her? Be my guest. Otherwise, I suggest you leave defending this city to the people who spent their lives doing it.
It is, okay. Talk to Keone Alpin. I guess she's the one with the new ideas, so let's have a chat.
Ecologies are living things. They move, they change. The way we handle Ashta works, for now. So we have to be prepared.
Well, you sure don't look like you're delivering the capacitors I'm waiting for. Something I can do for you?
I hear you have some new tech for defending the city.
No. That's not really accurate. It is, however, slightly less openly hostile a reaction than I've gotten around here, so I'll take it. I'm not sure what you've heard, or, quite frankly, why this seems to be getting around the way it is. Despite assertions to the contrary, I'm not attempting to run anyone out of a job, or open the city gates to allow Ashta to come pouring in. Nor am I in any way attempting to make a statement about the competence of the current security forces and or apparatus in Akila City. I hope that clears things up.
Well, that was definitive.
Got it. Makes total sense.
Fantastic. I need to prove that what I'm working on can make a positive difference. Then you'll see it my way. I could really use some help, in fact, just to make sure this all goes off without a hitch. Would you be willing to place some sensors for me?
Sensors? What?
Yeah, I need them to start gathering data. Pretty simple. I could do it myself, but at this point, I think Davis may be having someone tail me. He's that flustered.
Okay, well, sure, we can put up a few sensors, kill a few Ashta in the process if we need to.
That is great news. Just take these and stick them in specific spots in the city along the wall. When you're done, come find me. I'll find something to do in the meantime to give myself an air of plausible deniability.
Plausible deniability? I mean, are we doing something illegal here, or what's the deal? Okay, so apparently, yeah, maybe this is all outside of the city somewhere, but anyway, let's get to it. I don't think it should be too difficult.
Vigilance.
And yeah, I'm sort of hoping that by having Andrasia with us, we can improve our relationship and she'll finally sort of reveal what sort of task she wants us to do for her. I assume she's got something in mind at some point. Or perhaps maybe we haven't reached Varun space and therefore we haven't unlocked the ability to do her quest line yet. One sensor down, another three to go.
This farm. Yes, Aggies. I have spent far too much time here. I do not recommend it.
Aggies. Okay, I haven't really been into this bar before, I don't think.
Locals can be especially colorful here.
Ethan Nash.
If you need something to ease the pain, I can set you up.
That's a gang tattoo. Who'd you run with?
Good eye. It's not something most people pick up on. I grew up in the stretch, and I hated it. I was ready to do anything to get out. Gang called the Mad Dog sent some recruits, and I signed up. Did a lot of things I'm not proud of. Those days are over now. I got out, Aggie gave me a second chance. I intend to make the most of it.
Cool.
Enjoy Aggies.
Oh, and this is Aggie. You run this place all by yourself?
You surprised or disappointed? It's my name on the outside, isn't it? Been here too damn long to let someone else come in and muck it up. Hell, even finding decent help isn't worth the trouble half the time. Ethan's got half a brain in his head, seems like, so maybe he'll work out.
Is the stretch always this crowded?
More and more as time goes on. Plenty of folks looking to get out from under the thumb of the UC, or taking their first steps to being independent. City's been slow to keep up with all the new people. Took them forever to put up the outer walls, and at this rate, they'll need to expand again soon.
All right.
Yes? What?
Don't seem to be too friendly around here. There's one more sensor, so a couple more I guess we're only putting the sensors in the stretch.
Hey, no funny stuff with that boost pack.
I do recall being here a few times, though.
I checked my account yesterday, and it was all there. But I haven't tried to withdraw yet.
I guess the poorest bunch of Akila City live here. Isabel King.
Maybe we could invite the Johnsons over?
Those sad sacks in my home?
If you won't help Marco find a job, least we could do is give them a good meal.
I don't mean to be callous, but working with the Low House, I see how bad people got it. We have trouble looking after our own. Much less some UC transplants.
The Jansons are good people, Axel.
You remember the colony wars? Because I do. I lost kin. Now you expect me to feed them, give them jobs? That could go to our people?
The Jansons aren't the whole United Colonies. They're just people. If you don't want to help them, what about their little one, Liv?
I've had enough of this. I dream about one day having my own plot of land. I've seen people do bad things for money. Even some friends. That bill always comes due.
Hard work and grit pay off, and my husband and I work hard to feed Akila City. You might have had a meal with produce we farmed.
I know I sound like a commercial right now, but I've been to other stores.
I think we probably dealt with them before for one of those, I think, charity sort of missions that we were involved in. Okay, so all of the scanners are in. Need to go back to Keone. What's going on here? Again, someone's little house. Alien extravaganza.
Step right in, ma'am, and feast your eyes on the marvelous attractions of Honest Earl's Alien Extravaganza.
Honest Earl.
I can read this.
Of course you can. But can you believe your senses? Creatures great and small from the furthest reaches of the settled systems.
Here? In the stretch?
Yes, right here, right now. Things you would never see in a million years for just a small price of admission.
Huh. Well, it's not that much.
Come right in.
Admission is kind of cheap. It's probably worth a laugh, at least. I'm surprised there's a place like this in Akila.
Welcome, welcome! Let me ask you a simple question, friend. Are you prepared to see something so wondrous and strange that you're sure never to forget it?
You're gonna try and sell me something, aren't you?
I'm offering you the chance to see something truly exotic and unique. Now, a small remittance is involved, yes. But if you allow me to explain, I think you'll agree it's a price that's more than fair.
All right, tell me more.
With pleasure. We got animals from the deepest, darkest corners of the settled systems. What you'll see will delight and amaze. Just a modest fee, and you can feast your eyes! I envy you, truly, for this opportunity.
10 credits, okay. Yeah, sure. Let's see what you have in there.
Step right through this door and take as long as you like perusing the menagerie. Oh, and, please don't attempt to feed the creatures. In fact, it's best if you don't touch them, either.
Okay, okay. What happens if we don't pay him and just waltz in here? I guess he might turn around and tell us to go away or something. A bunch of bones and stuff. Ooh, okay. So he's got a bit of a... would we call this a fossil collection? I guess it's just a bone collection. At what point do bones become fossils? I guess it's maybe when... they've petrified or something, maybe. Is that even a thing? Carl. Is that the only thing that he's got? Oh, okay. And there's another thing here. Blue Mox. Interesting. I mean, people can literally see these things from outside, though. Why would you need to pay 10 credits to look at these things? 10 credits to look at these things from closer. Okay, it's just the John. I guess that's it.
Honest Earl, that's what folks call me. You know, you don't just get a name like that by accident.
Is this for real?
Absolutely. There's a reason folks around here call me Honest Earl. Tell your friends about us.
Well, heck, tell total strangers. Everyone should see.
Right. Anyway, that was an interesting distraction.
Anyone would spend credits on this instead of taking a trip to see real alien life.
Yes, well, taking a trip to see real alien life does come with some dangers, doesn't it? So, there's that. Stone Root Inn. Have we been in there? I don't think so.
If you ever find an old Earth printing of City of God, I am looking for it for ages.
City of God.
You got some good news, I hope?
I sure do. Your sensors have been placed.
Well, that's that then. So, this next part, it's a bit delicate. See that guard tower across the way there? I need to get in there and make a few small modifications to the terminal inside. I don't have the processing power to collate all the data that'll be coming in from the sensors. The existing network does.
Okay, I'll take care of it.
Oh goodness, I really am bad at communicating sometimes. I have that part well in hand. The, guard standing outside there, he's not gonna let me in. I need you to distract him.
Approaching from behind and going for a swift elimination would be effective, but perhaps a bit more permanent than we need right now.
I should only need a few moments, so I don't know, convince him to take a break or something. Or if you're feeling particularly rebellious, maybe give him some official business to attend to. I believe it's what Davis would refer to as a ruckus. As soon as you've got him occupied, I'll scoot in and out before anyone notices. Okay? Let's do this.
Steal something in front of the guard. Okay, so that's an optional thing. I think we can probably convince him, though, with our persuasion level. So, yeah, just up there. Let's do it. Probably want to boost our chances though, so why don't we get slightly tipsy here before we engage in conversation. Chunk's wine should do the trick.
Ever run into spacers? Scumbags and scavengers. They're like vultures picking away at the leftovers of the colony war. You'll find them scouring through old labs and facilities, taking whatever's not nailed down.
What brings you to the wall? Boredom, because if that's what you're looking for, you've hit the jackpot.
Oh, we could just pull out our badge. I can't get into it, but I need a few minutes here alone. It's for a good cause.
And I'm just supposed to take this on what, faith?
Pretty much, man. Look, everything's fine. Nothing to worry about.
I'll be the judge of that.
Listen. I've got a job to do, and I need you to be away from here.
Yeah, I hear you.
I'm sure we can work something out.
I hear you. I guess I believe you. Just don't do anything I'll regret, okay?
Alright. should be gone now. And what do we need to do next? We need to... Oh, okay, we need to just talk to Keone again. She's there.
That's all settled then. Thanks for the assist. Hope you're none too worse for wear.
A frozen iceberg, fishing for a dinner that will eat him.
You should tell the guards what you've done.
Oh, I intend to. Once enough data has been collected, I'll have the proof I need to convince them, especially Davis, that my technology is useful. If you're curious, come back tomorrow. I might even have preliminary findings.
Alright, so I guess we can check back in with this Keone at some point. But we don't have to do that right away. I'm thinking we want to have a chat with this person here. Talk to Marco Jansen about his family that's hit hard times since they're immigrated to Akila City. I think we were just hearing about this from the two before who are bickering. Might be able to help them out. Okay, Marco Jansen. Let's see where this fella is. Oh, right here.
I'm just thankful to be alive after that robbery. Thank you. Thank God. I thought the Shaw gang was going to kill all the hostages in the bank. You were amazing. Thank you.
I'm just glad everyone made it out alive.
We wouldn't have made it without you. Listen, I have nothing. Less than nothing. My family moved here from Sidonia, hoping for a better life. Sometimes I just feel cursed. And I could live with that if it was just me. But Simone? And little Liv?
I'm sorry to hear your family's got it so rough.
So many people here look past my family being UC and are just like that. Kind. A real sense of community. I just need a job and we could be happy here. Sorry, you should feel good. Super good about what you did at Galbank. You want to talk about anything?
Oh, okay.
I just need a real chance. But there's too little opportunity. And it's hard to compete with native Freestar folk.
What made you want to leave Sidonia?
No, we don't have any.
Got tired of living under the boot. The UC always tells you what to do and how to do it. If you're down, they want to keep you there. I thought maybe hard work and patience would lead to better things. But it became clear that that was never going to happen. The only way out was to leave the UC behind. So I brought the family here. Things aren't much better, but at least I don't have the piglets breathing down my neck anymore.
I don't know.
Are you going to apply
Seems to
for
think
the job?
That the grass is greener on the other side when, in fact, it's so just as green, or in this case, just as brown. Sidonia, I don't know. I mean, if he's gonna live in the stretch of Akila City, that's probably worse off than Sidonia. Just being honest with you guys. I'd like to help you and your family, if there is a way.
We've been given as much charity as I can stomach. Without the Low House, I mean, there's something, but it's a hell of a thing to ask.
I'm curious what you're talking about.
Remember? You asked. Simone, my wife, has got a cousin, Milena Axelrod. Truthfully, I never much cared for Milena. But she runs freight, and I know her routes sometimes take her this way. Milena is family. Might be she'd do something for her kin. I'm looking for a job, and I'll do anything. Well, anything legal. Milena's United Colonies, like us, and I know she's got problems of her own with Akila City.
What's her problem with Akila City?
She clams up the times I've asked. Not even Simone knows. I'm sure she's run afoul of the law somehow. That's kind of how she operates.
Well, I've got a ship, so it shouldn't be a problem to talk to Milena.
You are an answer to our prayers. Milena called Simone yesterday. I'm pretty sure she's still in the system. Just giving me any hope. It's a lot.
So, this is a really weird request, because I don't exactly understand what he wants from Milena. We apparently just need to talk to her. Maybe he just wants a job from her? Possibly.
Sure. It's not a life of luxury, but I'm getting by, you know?
I'm not asking for handouts. But if you got some extra credits... Gonna crash at Sammy's for a week. Hey. Can't beat free room and board.
Right! There you are!
Do we know each other?
Oh my god! What? What's going on?
You're clearly on something.
You? I can't believe it.
Well, okay. What about Sammy?
Go easy on Coma, okay? Everyone mocks him because he's usually spaced out. But I think deep inside, he's in a lot of pain.
Is Mooch a friend?
Kind of. He crashes at my place. But man, he could stay too long. I kind of want to tell him enough is enough. But I don't need that drama in my life right now.
How are you and Coma doing?
Great, I guess. Coma's riding high. As in on drugs. I was trying to put it politely. I mean, I get it. We're in the slums. It's not the first time I've seen that. But with him, it's pretty much every minute he isn't working in the fields. His whole life is just work. Get high and sleep.
Hmm. If it bothers you that much, then you should confront him about it.
Tried it already. He won't talk about it. In fact, it just makes him hit the stuff that much harder. The best I can hope for now is that he'll find some way to pull himself out of it. Guess that's just life in the slums. You either survive it or you don't. Keep on keeping on.
Okay. Well, let's try and find this Milena person. Actually, we should be able to just fast travel there, hopefully. No? Maybe Milena's somewhere in the starport. Possibly. All right, let's get ourselves there.
Did you see the landing not too long ago?
Yeah,
I don't
definitely
care
don't
about the evidence or data. Sometimes
hang out here in Akila City very much, do we? Ah, this is already outside of the wall. Oh god. Alright. Can we get back in from here? I mean, alternatively, I could probably just fast travel to the ship. And we can just get out of the ship and then continue on that way.
Always a satisfying moment to return to.
Captain, greetings.
Alright, oh! We apparently do need to go into the ship. Alright. Well, let's go then.
Thank you.
I like our new ship and all, but it is a little bit confusing to get around in it. Still. So again, where are we going? Is in the Akila system, so I guess what they mean is it might be in orbit or something?
Time to greet the stars.
Now between this episode and the last one, guys, I actually looked at whether or not we can upgrade our shipbuilding skills, but apparently that's not possible, that's because I haven't exactly placed unique parts or enough unique parts to get to get the skill that we need. So I might invest the skill point that we've been saving up into something else for the time being. Where the hell am I supposed to be going? There. Why can't I fast travel there though? Jeez. Okay. Well, let's go. I guess this is the person that we need to see? Or is it? I think so. Let's just see if these guys have anything for us though. A few ship parts wouldn't be a bad thing. Let's do that then.
Green lights on outer hatch. We're docked.
Bit random, but okay. right. Person's just like waiting for us right here. Milena!
Doesn't get the juices flowing. You're doing it wrong. It's supposed to be safe around here, but Cheyenne has always been just a giant bastard to me. unless you're a native. In which case, oh my god, I love what you've done with the place.
How'd Cheyenne get on your bad side?
I swear, every time I come through here, something goes to shit. But it always calls me back. Take now. I'm just supposed to be doing some deliveries, and whammo! Pirates! Cheyenne's going to get me one of these days.
So, you enjoy fighting pirates?
No, not one bit. I enjoy surviving fighting pirates. Big difference.
Okay. Marco Jensen sent me. His family is in dire financial straits and need your help.
I knew it! Damon should have told me. Her and Marco are so damned proud. I'd love to help them out. Might be I've got a checkered history with the fine city of Akila. If you clear up any lingering hard feelings, then I could resume doing business there. I'd set up Stickabazas Marco as my official importer. Then wins all around.
How'd you get blacklisted at Akila?
I used to do cargo hauls for the mayor, and he got really upset that I might have been carrying more than I ought to. We had some words, maybe one fat lip, not mine, and now I'm persona non grata.
Okay. Well, how can I clear things up for you?
Well, two paths I see. The Trade Authority's got a fixer named Tom Starrett. He might be able to facilitate things. Or Mayor Cartwright. God, that windbag. Well, if he'd take a sorry, that would work. Fat chance. Either way, I expect credits will be on the line. On the back end, I could afford to give you a taste of the action. Not sure it'll cover the fees.
Alright, I think I might try the Trade Authority route here. Yeah.
Music to my ears, friend. Marco doesn't deserve you. But Simone, she's one of the good ones. You square things away. Just let Marco know.
All right. Get Milena access to Akila City. Sure. Well, let's head back there then. And, we need to have a chat with the Trade Authority on Akila City. See if we can...
Textbook there. We're free.
I guess, do some deals with them. Not always keen on dealing with the Trade Authority, as I keep saying, but guess we don't really have much of an option here. I don't know about her sort of getting an apology from the mayor of Akila City. That seems a little bit too far-fetched, especially if she's the one who gave him the fat lip. So, yeah. Let's try and see what we can do with the Trade Authority. So, I might take this opportunity to spend our point. And yeah, I might go into a little bit more combat here because we haven't really invested in combat for a while and I feel like our damage is tapering off. We could either go into ballistic weapons and increase the damage on ballistic weapons, or we could do pistol certification. This does like 50% more damage. That's pretty decent, but I'm thinking maybe the ballistic weapons might be better because we've got quite a few ballistic weapons that we're using currently on the regular. So let's do that. And we might go into pistol certification next. If we do have a spare point for that, that is. You never know, I might sort of pivot and want to invest in something else. Alright, so we've got a few options here, or... yeah, I guess maybe it's pointing us to all of the options. Yeah, we just need to make sure that we're actually going into the Trade Authority office and not, like, the mayor's office. I don't know if the mayor would be in the rock. Oh no, the mayor's just over there. Have we spoken to the mayor before? I feel like maybe we have. Yeah. It's that guy. Yeah, we did a job for him already. All right. Down here then. And perhaps maybe this might actually give us an idea of where the bloody Trade Authority is located in the first place. Okay, well, this is not the Trade Authority office, but anyway.
I do jobs for the Trade Authority. There's always something. Listen, no offense, but I'm swamped.
What does a fixer exactly do?
I'm sure I don't know what you're talking about.
I want to get Milena Axelrod permission to do business in Akila City.
Milena wants back? The Trade Authority always likes facilitating business, but she's got a considerable bounty on her. Captains associated with us can land here. I even have some credentials on hand. And wouldn't you know it, the captain's name is blank. If she had set credentials and put her name on them, well, she couldn't land. But if any other name was in there, any name at all, well, I think that might clear it up.
And the authorities wouldn't care?
The Trade Authority has a separate arrangement. As long as a hypothetical captain kept a low profile, why she could do business here indefinitely. She should talk with us. We have a lot of common ground.
I could always use some extra credentials.
I'll contact Milena right away. I'm sure she'll put them to good use. Pleasure doing business with you.
Now we can at least put this matter behind us.
Yep, okay. And say that again. Do we have to do anything else? Yeah, we need to just check in with Marco once more.
Wonder how the Crimson Fleet seems to be everywhere.
I was gonna say someone seems to have a bit of a veggie garden going there, but that's actually not a veggie garden, it's a succulent garden. Talk to Davis Wilson. Why? Why would I want to do that? Maybe someone's just mentioned something in passing and we were supposed to have listened to it, but anyway. Again, that is one of my biggest gripes, actually, with the way quests are given to us. People seem to just blurt out stuff, and the game devs are hoping that you stop and listen, but it's not exactly realistic, is it? I feel like they should actually have people sort of, you know, holler at you or something like that and ask for your attention before they actually give out the quest to you, you know?
Every time I feel queasy asking for help, I remember Liv. It's all for her. Milena contacted me. She's making me her official importer. I'm not sure how much it pays, but I'll take it. You have no idea what you've done.
Give Milena a chance. She's fun.
My problem with her hasn't been whether she's good company, but I'll try. I can't wait to tell Simone. This is the first ray of sunshine we've seen in years.
Okay, and somehow we've gotten 12,500 creds out of that. Again, whether or not it makes sense, questionable, because I would have imagined that he would need all of those creds to himself. What's going on up here? Nothing. Right, let's see. In terms of things happening in Akila, I think the only thing is this: false positives, waiting 24 hours. UT for Keone. So it does actually give the option to speak to Davis Wilson already, though. So, okay, that's what it was. I'm not sure about that, because I'd sort of want to wait for Keone to get some results. So I guess maybe we could let the outcome, or decide the outcome, depending on who we speak to first, perhaps. I might actually follow up with Percival with what's going on with that tree. Seems like a good thing to get into at this point. Percival. Oh, hang on, no. This is not the tree thing. I'm thinking of Kelton. Oh, hang on. This is the Kelton quest line. I need to get the tree branch from Leah Kassler, and this is in Akila City as well, if I'm not mistaken. So we need to convince Leah Kassler, to part with these tree branches. So yeah, let's do that. Might need a little bit more of our persuasion once more. It's been a lot of talking in this episode. A lot of persuasion and dialogue options, not a lot of shooting. Which, you know, I mean, we don't have to shoot people constantly, do we?
Hi! Please feel free to have a look around. It's the reason I started this place.
Okay. Don't mind us. We are going to get drunk. And now we're gonna have a chat with her.
I have artifacts that date all the way back to the time of Solomon Coe himself.
Good for you. How's the museum going?
Very well. People are proud of their history here, so we get more visitors than I was expecting. So it gets pretty busy here, especially with school field trips.
I do travel a lot, and I can keep my eyes open for things for your museum if you want.
There are some things I would kill to have. I mean, wait, not literally. But I would pay a lot for. You see, the Coe family lost a treasure trove of old historic documents ages ago. And those documents would be priceless to have here.
What sort of documents are you looking for?
Well, all of them were owned by our city's founder, Solomon Coe. He's more than that, really. He's one of the greatest heroes of the settled systems. These documents would be, like I said, priceless to the museum and to our guests.
I can see why you'd want them in your museum.
Their absence pains me. Jacob Coe and I have talked at length, and his great-grandfather was a troubled man. He sold off various historic documents to cover debts. They could be anywhere. If you find any of that trove of documents, I will pay dearly for it.
Okay. I'll keep my eyes open for them.
Thank you. Think of the future generations that could benefit from seeing such important history.
Okay, we've got an activity for that. Return Akila City Charter to Leah Kassler. Do I already have something for it? I have found something for your museum.
Let me see. Oh dear lord. It's real. It still exists. This is the original charter for Akila City. And you can see their signatures. This is really the birth of the Free Star Collective. The core philosophy of limited government and inalienable rights. All here. Thank you. If you find anything else, please come back.
Okay, cool. I remember the whole quest line with Sam. We did find a few historic things, right? Historic documents. Anyway, I'd like to talk to you about a tree branch.
That is not something I expected to hear today. I assume you're somehow associated with the United Colonies. I've received some odd messages of late.
What sort of messages have you received?
Several that bordered on being incomprehensible. Honestly, I thought it was some kind of strange prank until now. A bunch of gibberish about dire consequences and frequency modulation and genetic reconstruction. It all came across as rather unhinged. Well, I'm afraid you've wasted your time because I'm not authorized nor particularly inclined to release any of our pieces. That includes 100-year-old tree branches. Sorry, but it's staying in storage.
Okay. Well, I mean, the whole gibberish thing, that's Kelton for you. So, we have the option to either steal this thing, which I'm definitely not going to be doing.
Your help in preserving and sharing Akila City history is greatly appreciated.
Look, I really need that tree branch.
I hear what you're saying, but I'm afraid it's out of the question.
Look, that branch is a vital piece of information on important xenobotanical work.
Now you're just trying to confuse me. It's a dead branch, and it belongs to the museum.
If I don't get that branch, things could be disastrous for the people of New Atlantis.
Huh. A disaster befalling New Atlantis? Hard to get upset about that.
I can be a very annoying man when I need to be. If you don't give me the branch, I won't stop asking for it.
Go on. Keep asking. I still won't hand it over. I can't just hand out museum exhibits to anyone. It doesn't work that way. If this isn't some sort of hustle, go talk to Earl Fulton. I believe he may still have some leftover scraps. That, of course, is a different kind of hustle altogether.
Speak to Earl Fulton or steal the branch, okay? Well, I was going to be prepared to steal it because we do have the stealth and the hacking or digipicking skill just in case, but something about scraps? I don't really get it. Let's find out. Let's find out. Yeah, so she was a bit of a tough nut to crack. Maybe I should have gone with the Pinot Noir instead of the chunks. We are going a little bit cheap by taking the chunks. Maybe I could have even taken some Azure or something. Azure? Not Azure. Velocity.
I must ask, if you or...
Honest this
Earl,
guy.
That's what folks call me. you don't just get a name like that by accident.
Leah Kasler says you have some wood from a new Atlantean tree?
Confound that woman. I paid good credits for that lumber, which, by the way, she was just going to throw out, and she has no right to say otherwise. Why, if I had a receipt, I would gladly produce it. And after all that, none of my exotic beasts would even touch the stuff. In the end, I'm the one who was robbed.
If it's useless to you, would you be willing to part with it?
Sorry, what? You're not here to settle accounts? Huh. May I ask what your business is, then?
New Atlantis may be in danger, and that wood is crucial to saving it.
You don't say. Well, my friend, you will be happy to know that this is your lucky day. I do indeed still happen to have some of that exquisite hardwood and would be willing to part with it for just a few credits. I'm thinking perhaps 500 credits ought to cover the storage expenses, not to mention what it'll take to purchase alternate food supplies for my exhibits. I think that's a more than fair deal, don't you?
500 creds? Didn't you say it was worthless to you?
Why, no, not at all. It may not at present appeal to any of my attraction's inhabitants, but I never know what wonders I may acquire in the future. It would just be bad business to part with it and not expect some amount of compensation. Surely you can understand that.
All right. Should we steal the stuff from the museum or pay 500 creds? You know what? Screw it. Let's give him 500 creds.
Wonderful, wonderful. Now, let me just see if I can locate some of that wood. Ah, here you are. Well, pleasure doing business with you, friend. Take care now.
All right, we've got the ancient branch from these Akila City people. You know, the people from Akila City, they're a little bit arrogant, aren't they, when it comes to dealing with the UC and New Atlantis. They don't seem to care at all about the plight of their neighbors. Despite our efforts in the Terramorph stuff to, you know, try and keep things fair. Anyway, let's make our way to New Atlantis in that case, and we might end up ending the episode there by having a chat with Kelton. And that might actually be enough time to wait for what we need to do back in Akila City, because we do need to sort of wait 24 hours before having a chat with, I forget her name now, but anyway. Keone, that's it. So yeah, I feel like we've spent the majority of the episode here in Akila City, and that's fair enough because we've done something similar when we were dealing with people in Sidonia. We sort of spent a lot of time there, didn't we?
By the way, Captain.
Kelton?
Akila City has me.
I do appreciate that not every
have you paid a visit to Miss Castler in Akila City?
City?
I most certainly
this
have.
City is far too grand for such a fate.
I got this branch from Earl Fulton. Hopefully it works.
Earl Fulton? I have no idea who that is. Hopefully he's trustworthy.
Me too.
Well, I'll trust your judgment. And beggars can't be choosers. Let's give it a shot. Now, I just need a moment to analyze this and synthesize an audio response to our friend here. Right, so we'll feed in a sample. Now the program will incorporate the genetic and chemical makeup of the sample, extrapolating the size and structure of the original tree. This was put together rather hastily, so complete accuracy is impossible. But I'm hoping it's enough. There it is. Our best hope for a positive solution to this mess.
All right. So the results are instant, or what's the deal here?
So, we now have a simulated response to our tree. All that's left is to play it.
I hope that the outcome of this quest doesn't get affected by how I obtained the branch. Because if we needed like a better quality branch, for example, from the museum, then I would have totally gone for that. Anyway, how do we play this?
An excellent question. I have been wondering myself. I've been forced to listen to this SSNN kiosk chatter incessantly this entire time. I think it could be put to better use. We don't have time to go through the proper channels, but if you can find a terminal and get this uploaded into their system, it might do the trick.
Exposure to the frequency in this simulation could be potentially harmful. Are you sure we should do this?
You're right. There's a chance that there could be some minor adverse side effects, but none would be life-threatening. We won't play the broadcast loud or long enough to cause any major or permanent damage to humans or other organic life. And aside from that, if we don't calm this tree down soon, well, I fear that the vibrations it's emitting will eventually reach such strength it could severely damage our internal organs.
And if it doesn't work?
Then I fear all this hard work will be for naught. I would hate to see this tree come down, but we may be out of options.
Using the SSNN broadcast tower, I mean, that seems illegal.
Perhaps, but desperate times, and all that. Certainly, if you have some other option, by all means, take advantage of it.
It is still odd to me. All of this effort over saving a tree.
Saving this tree could also save lives. We have to do this for the good of New Atlantis.
All right, I'll see what I can do.
I have no doubt that you will.
Unload audio to an SSNN terminal. Isn't there one just here, though? Oh, okay. So there is. Oh, yeah, right here.
The latest Interceptor movie also set records of production costs and delays.
Oh, okay. I guess I can't just do it from there. I have to do it from somewhere else. Let's see. We're going to the commercial district. Where exactly do we need to go? Up here, apparently. Is it the SSNN headquarters or something, or? Oh, yes, it is. We haven't really been here, have we? Settled Systems News Network.
But if you've seen something interesting, let me know. If it pans out into a full story, you'll be compensated. Welcome to SSNN, where the news never sleeps. If you're part of the David Baron fan club, try not to inflate his ego too much. He's liable to burst.
might be able to hook you up with some merch. Maybe get you a...
Who are you?
A cog in the machine. That's all I can do. If you mean literally, Nadia Mufaz, head researcher of the office. So if we got any facts wrong, I'm the one who files your complaint into the shredder.
But why are you sitting out here in the receptionist's desk? That's the real question, really. What's your problem with David Barron?
We spend hundreds of hours digging into stories, sorting the lies from the damned lies. Then David performs a 2-minute segment and wins an award. Who'd have a problem with that?
Well, David seems like a vain egomaniac.
Sounds like you know him personally. Let's take a look at you. You're not from around here. My guess is you work, really work, for a living. I bet you have a story or two. I have a feeling about such things.
My life has gotten very weird and interesting lately.
Sounds like an old pickup line. But it really has, hasn't it? I'm interested only in primary sources. So things you've seen and or done that are newsworthy. No hearsay. So, what do you got for me?
Oh wow, we've got a lot of stuff here. Look
up to the grind.
I am gonna leave that for now because there's so much that we could tell her. Perhaps maybe some stuff that we shouldn't really be telling her, but we have the option to anyway, maybe. Alright, let's get this broadcast in. Okay, there we go. So we've uploaded the sound file there.
Travels significantly slower than blood.
So what happens next? Run a diagnostic. Okay, right. We've got to do that next. Diagnostic file found, running. And now we just got to return to the tree and see the results of our work. Okay. Cool. I think that's probably something that we'll do when we come back in the next episode, guys. So this is probably a good place for a bit of a break. Hope you enjoyed this episode. As usual, leave a like or a dislike or a comment or two down below. Stay true. I'll see you guys in the next one.